I guess the question is, victim of a crime. You've talked about the crime of impersonation
before. Yeah, in the state of California, as is the case in some other states, it's a crime to impersonate someone online. The problem here is twofold. Number one, was this a real person? I mean, the impersonation here wasn't actually of someone who existed. It was taking a photo and making up a name and a personality. And as a result, that's a problem in any potential prosecution. Number two, you'd still need to have the intent to harm, defraud, threaten, intimidate, etc. And in this case, they might say, well, that certainly wasn't our intent. It was supposed to be a joke. It wasn't supposed to be to harm, as it turned out. Now, remember, this is just a misdemeanor, too. This is not a serious crime.
I guess you could imagine also that perhaps Manti Te'o could have some kind of a civil case. And one of the other things we're learning overnight is he produced a receipt of flowers he actually sent to the funeral home for Lene Kakua after he found out she had supposedly died.
If this was a real investigation of a real crime, that would be really significant, right? The authorities would say, wait a sec, this really backs up his account. As a result, we shouldn't be looking at him. We should be looking at others involved in this. But as a practical matter, what this does is it simply backs up his story. It backs up his account that he believed that she was real. And it certainly helps him in the court of public opinion.
But hard to believe we're going to see any charges here.
Yeah, and hard to believe that we don't learn any new details. I mean, remember, this story is broken almost a week ago, and we've learned very little new since that happened.
But we're going to learn a lot more when we see Manti Te'o tomorrow on KDOK. Okay, Dan Abrams, thanks very much.